It's smell distinct. They say it's one way to know you're in Nampa when you get hit with that odor of burnt Reese's peanut butter cups. Or maybe you think it smells like musty steamed broccoli. Whichever, those that work there say the sugar beet factory in Nampa smells like money. 114 years ago today in 1906, the Western Idaho Sugar Company sliced its very first sugar beet. A year later, the company merged with two others to become the Utah Idaho Sugar Company. Then disputes with the railroad union and an infestation of white flies ruined the crop. So in 1910, the plant closed and moved its operations full-time to Utah. By 1915, the Amalgamated Sugar Company came back to the Gem State and opened a factory in Twin Falls. That was followed by a second factory, which opened near Paul in 1917. Sugar beets wouldn't be processed in Nampa, though, for another 25 years. In 1942, Amalgamated Sugar opened its Nampa factory on Karcher Road. In 2017, on its 75th anniversary, Joe Paris went to Nampa for a look inside the factory.
These towering smokestacks at the Amalgamated Sugar factory in Nampa are one of the most recognizable sites in the valley. But many would say there's something even more recognizable about the sugar factory, the smell of production.
It's kind of a sweet, pungent odor, you know, but some of us like it.
Not everyone agrees, but production manager Tim Van Deventer says he's gotten used to it.
I started actually as a sweeper. I just finished my 39th campaign. This will be my 40th campaign coming up this fall.
For Tim, that recognizable smell is also special.
My dad worked here for 40 years. It smells like my dad.
Whether you like the smell or not, the sugar made between these walls has been a part of this community for a long time. The factory began operating in 1942 and quickly provided hundreds of jobs for people across the Treasure Valley. Fast forward exactly 75 years to the day, and that's still the case. Today, about 500 employees are celebrating the big anniversary.
Well, yeah, it's always been here. It's always been. Everyone knows where it is.
For a lot of families in the valley, this factory is just part of the family.
It's kind of a family tradition, and you talk about the smell, my wife doesn't mind it at all. It reminds her of her dad, too.
Of course, the smell isn't the only part of the tradition. For 75 years, hardworking men and women have produced a lot of sugar here. Along with factories in Twin Falls and Paul, Idaho, Amalgamated Sugar produces up to 1.6 billion pounds of sugar every year. And this year, production in Nampa broke their all-time record.
This year, we're processing sugar for 360 days. So this is the longest sugar processing run we've had.
These days, the factory puts out about 2 million pounds of sugar per day for more than 20 different labels. You'll find the sugar made here in stores throughout the region. But Tim says there's something even more than the sugar and smell that comes from this factory. He says that's hard-working Idahoans.
Almost everybody that you meet in town, you tell them where you work at the sugar factory, and they go, well, I know so-and-so that works there, or my dad worked there, or something like that. It's a real strong connection with the community.
A community that's proud of their sugar, maybe that smell too. Joe Paris, Idaho's News Channel 7.
Wow, 360 out of 365 days in 2017. Well, that's because sugar beets are perishable, so factories typically have to operate around the clock. And sugar beets, or beet sugar, I should say, represents about 54% of all sugar produced in the U.S. Idaho is the second largest sugar beet producer in the country, or the processor, I should say. Harvest season is just getting underway right now. It's going to run through October, and when they're fully grown, maybe you didn't know this, sugar beets typically about a foot long, and they weigh about 2 to 5 pounds. They're large.